we're on the road. Carl the Envelope, we're going to do a little digging today. We're also going to stop. Carl's favorite cheesesteak spot is here in Greensboro, a place called Gassan's. We're going to try to hit up maybe two record stores. One is more of a used spot. Our pal Harley at Soul Relief Records, and then Hippo Records, which has a lot more like modern metal, punk titles and stuff, reissues and whatnot. Carl, what are you after? What genre are you going for today? Or are you specifically looking for?
Honestly, right now I don't have anything in particular. I'm just on a full-on browse and dig and see what I find.
Hell yeah!
Always looking to pick up a little punk rock. Hadn't bought much of that lately. Been filling out the old metal collection lately, so probably stay away from that today unless I just find something that's just like, oh shit, I gotta have it.
Cool. Yeah, kind of the same. I'm also looking for punk and maybe some 80s metal as well. And always on the lookout for stoner, doom stuff. But probably more keyed in on punk than anything at the moment. So hopefully we'll have some good stuff to report.
Oh, it's drunk out tonight. It's settling like the dew, and I have even noticed that the walls are plastered too. The bartender's staggering, he surely had his share. Let's have another drink, we can't go home, it's too darn drunk out there.
Alright, so we're here at Gazan's, Carl's favorite cheesesteak spot. Let's get a shot of that, Carl.
It's still as good as I remember.
Famous Greensboro cheesesteaks, as famous as Greensboro gets for cheesesteaks. So. Of course, I'm low carb, and so I did the grilled chicken salad, which also looks damn good. Gassan's and Greensboro. So right across the street from Gassan's, where we just ate, is actually a record store right there, but they suck, so we're going to go support some actual local NC homies.
Well, bad news. Soul Relief is closed today, July 30th. That sucks. We missed you, Harley, damn it, boy.
Well, we've made it to Hippo Records since Soul Relief was closed. Carl's gonna buy records.
Probably.
Tell me what you got.
All right, found four albums. Got into some punk rock. Got some Good Riddance. Don't have this one, but been a big fan of Good Riddance from the late 90s, early 2000s. This is like 2006 Fat Records. And then I picked Propagandhi's most recent release. This one I think is 2017. Yeah, the boys have gotten old on the back cover.
Oh yeah, look at that.
But yeah. Been a big Propagandhi fan for a long time. And I had to grab a couple country albums. Been digging this, although I catch shit for it because Hardy is mainstream country. But the Hicks tape is a bunch of mix, a whole bunch of different artists with him. Different song, different artists on each song. And the last one I found was a live Tyler Childers. Live with the Red Barn Radio. Already a big fan of Tyler Childers, and this has a bunch of songs on it that I don't have, but I've heard. Mm-hmm. So yeah, four records, all newbies, no used today, and Yeah, good time for my first trip at Hippo.
What? Yeah, I was going to say, so what did you think of Hippo?
I dig it, man. They've got a lot of stuff. Good selection. A lot of records for the size space they got in there. But yeah, prices seem pretty fair all around. Good record store.
All right, so here's what I picked up at Hippo Records. Kind of blowing my wad for Dig of the Week, but whatever, man. Picking up a couple of 7-inch singles. A band called Beauregard, which it says blood, sweat, and psychedelic rock from 1971 Portland Wrestler, featuring Greg Sage of the Wipers. This is a Record Store Day reissue. That's why I picked it up, because Greg Sage from the Wipers, man. So I figured I'd take a chance on that. You know, I love the Wipers. Charlotte-based punk band. I know Pilmer's really tight with these guys, and these guys have been around forever. Anti-Scene. This is a 7-inch live recording from 2010, done in Speedfest in Holland. So I don't really know a whole bunch about these guys, but I know Pilmer loves them and tight with them, so I figured I'd take a chance on that. I love these guys, and I never buy their records, especially the first two. This is the second one, Sam Sham and the Pharaohs. I mean, you know, Woolly Bully. But I almost bought the... Straighten it up, Carl.
Not the pothole.
Yeah, I've almost bought the first one. I put it back a couple of times, and I kind of regret it, and I saw this. It was a decent price. It's like $12.99. I kind of just jumped on it. I love this shit, man. Some good old garagey rock and rolling shit. Man, I've talked about this band on the show a bunch. Fantastic stoner, psychedelic stoner stuff, like European Somali Yacht Club. This is a record that came out last year called Seas. I probably can't see it with a glare here. But this is a fantastic band. I've never actually seen them in the wild before. Like, it's ever. And every time I've been interested in ordering this online, but I mean, with the shipping, it's always coming from Europe. It costs you an arm and a leg. And so this was like $15 used. And I couldn't believe that. Really happy to run across that. Literally something you've never seen. Something that's been on my want list for a long time. As a recent convert, Halloween Walls of Jericho, the 85 joint. Been looking for this one. They had another Halloween that I'm interested in, but I decided to go with this one. And can't wait to bust this open, check it out. It's like a 2015 reissue. Love the Halloween. Had a good time at Hippo Records. Patrick there always does it right. Good prices, good selection, and just a kick-ass dude. For more information on these records, be sure to check out Thanks Grown Record Night, where I'll be probably going over them again, because not everybody is going to watch this or whatever. Peace!
What's your thoughts on MoFi?
Don't know. Hadn't heard anything about it until this weekend, and that's all I've been hearing about. So, seems like a bit of a scam to me. Those are my thoughts on MoFi.